Hi, I'm Adolf Ratzka. I've been studying, working, raising a family with the help of mechanical ventilation aids. For over half a century, I've been using various machines that help me breathe. Today, my breathing aid is the nasal mask that you see on my face. When I caught polio in 1961, I immediately needed mechanical ventilation. First, I had an iron lung. That's a big tube where only the head sticks out. I spent 3 months in there. After the iron lung, I had a rocking bed for 5 years. Imagine flying in an airplane with that kind of hardware, traveling by car, going to the movies, hanging out with friends. I couldn't do any of those. Isn't it incredible that today this nose mask here does the same job as these dinosaur contraptions some 50 years ago? Later on, I got a Cuirass or chest shell, which I used for almost 20 years. By the way, the gentleman in these pictures is not me. I never had such a nice mustache. In the first decades after polio, I needed mechanical ventilation only during the night for sleeping. That's my diaphragm is too weak and doesn't kick in automatically when I'm asleep. During the day, I managed on my own, breathing mainly with the auxiliary muscles around the neck. But in the 1980s, I started needing mechanical breathing support also during the day, when I was eating, talked a lot, or was very tired. I started using a thin air tube that I hold with my teeth. The tube is connected to a volume ventilator that is mounted under the seat of my power chair. The tube gave me enough air during the day for about 10 years. But a few years ago, it became obvious to my family, to others, and finally to myself that I was often short of breath. I'd been exhausted despite the air tube, particularly at dinner time, where I'd concentrate on my food without saying a single word, or at meetings where I'd make my points with as few words as possible. Brushing my teeth would get my heart pounding as if I'd run the 100-meter dash. Public speaking had become a nightmare. After a few minutes, my heart would be racing. Any spontaneity was gone, with my mind completely blank. All I could think of was to get it over with as fast as I could. I was running out of air when eating, brushing my teeth, and talking because I can't get air through the tube at the same time as I open my mouth, of course. My lips need to close around the tube to get air into my lungs. That's when I started looking for nasal masks for daytime use. Masks that would let me breathe through the nose. So no matter whether I had my mouth shut or open, no matter whether I'd be talking or eating, I'd get air through the nose. By that time, I had been using nasal masks for sleeping with good results. My early masks were designed in the 1980s by my friend Ernst Hermann, together with me. They were improved by dental technician Leonard Remmer, who lives in Sweden. Here's one of those masks. It is custom-made, molded to my nose and anchored to a dental plate on my upper teeth row. For the last few years, I experimented with ready-made CPAP masks. These masks are made for snorers and are designed for lying down and sleeping. But I need something for the day, for eating, brushing my teeth, for public speaking, and for yelling at my friends who are my age and we've become hard of hearing. So I tried these masks here, but they don't work for me. With some of them, I can't eat, others obstruct my eyes. Since January 2016, I've been using the mask that you see on my face now. It's a CPAP mask, and it is designed for people who snore in their sleep. That means before I could use it, I had to adapt it. I also had to adjust my ventilator and find the optimal settings for speaking with the mask. I can show you what I did. Just follow me to my next YouTube video with the title Breathing and Talking with CPAP Mask and Ventilator. See you there. Bye for now.